Do you believe in Santa Claus? There really is a Santa Claus, located only 10 miles north of the Ohio River near Lincoln State Park in southern Indiana. A land of fantasy where young and old alike can enjoy Christmas every day.
Hello there. Welcome to Santa Claus Land.
The history of the nation's first theme park is a story of a family which has for three generations dedicated itself to providing millions of guests with good old-fashioned family fun. Evansville, Indiana industrialist Lewis J. Cook created the nation's first theme park as a retirement project. He was troubled that the tiny hamlet of Santa Claus, Indiana was visited by children who were ultimately disappointed when they found out Santa was not there. With nine children of his own, Cook loved children, holidays, and celebrations. Santa Claus Land opened on August 3, 1946. The theme park included a toy shop, toy displays, themed children's rides, a restaurant, and, of course, Santa. When Cook's son Bill returned from World War II, he was curious to see his father's project. After overcoming doubts about the park's viability, Bill soon became the head of Santa Claus Land. In 1960, Bill married Santa's daughter, Patricia Yellick. He remained active in the family business until his death in 2001.
Bill was a very creative man, very intelligent man, had many ideas. My husband was very, very, very bright and very anxious and very amenable to change. And he saw that the future of Santa Claus Land would not be that of growth unless we changed to include other family members besides just small children. I remember very, very well us talking about the log flume and then meeting with a company and deciding to buy the log flume. And that was a big, big thing for us. For us, it was a move. It was the beginning of a move to what we call bigger rides, not large rides, but adult rides.
As the park expanded, the Cook family knew that Christmas was not the only theming possibility for the park. In 1984, Santa Claus Land grew to include Halloween and 4th of July sections, and the park's name was changed to Holiday World. Larger rides were added. In all, Holiday World features 100 acres of rides, shows, games, and attractions.
We were called by a friend of ours who said, why don't you all have a water park? You know, your Indiana summers are so hot. And I think Will was the person that got the call. And he and his father always talked things over. We talked together, the whole family. And we did, you know, those two slides at the entrance and the one lazy river. And we thought we had the most wonderful water park in the world. And people loved it. It was the beginning.
In 1993, Splash and Safari Water Park was added. It now includes 23 acres and features two wave pools, two action rivers, family raft rides, numerous water slides, plus several interactive family water play complexes.
We realize so much that we will be blessed if we give back. And it's a very important part of our family and of each of our individual lives. And so our contact with Easter Seals and the Rehabilitation Center has been huge over the years. And the first day of our season is the day when Easter Seals brings busloads and van loads of young people and their families. And they have the park to themselves. It's a day when they can get on the rides and they can take time and they can be helped. I'm always, and our employees are, just absolutely amazed by those children and by their families. And many of our employees say it's the best day of their year. I feel very strongly that we are a real, real catalyst for growth for young people, giving them their first job. I hope that we are giving them a great example. That's one of the things I feel a responsibility for, especially young people who don't have mentors, who don't have good positions or anybody to emulate in their lives, that I can be that person that helps them along encourages them. I have that opportunity every summer, and it's a wonderful feeling to have them write back or call back or email and say, you know, Mrs. Cook, I'm so grateful for what I learned, or to any of our people that have worked here and that have been in charge of young people. It's more needed now than ever. It's a great, and I love the young people. They are so bright, and they are so capable, and we just hear about the ones who aren't. And we need to celebrate and mentor the ones who are going to be our future leaders. They have to take our places someday.